Comedian turned mental health advocate Mike King has been named New Zealander of the Year. He's with me in the Auckland studio. Kia ora, good morning.
Morning, brother. How are you?
I'm well, thank you.
You know, I hope the government does the same thing with the DHBs. You know, we've got 20 DHBs out there fighting for this. That's 20 administrations. I'm hoping that they'll consolidate all of those.
Have you come in here to tell me about the politics sector?
No. I've been listening. I'm an avid listener.
You're taking this New Zealander of the Year role seriously, aren't you?
I'm an avid listener, and I just think, you know, it makes sense. 21 administrations, you know, there are DHBs that are doing well and there are DHBs that aren't doing well. Why don't we copy the ones that are doing well and get rid of the ones that aren't doing well? Sorry, I came in here with logic and common sense.
Well, you came in here with a gumboot, didn't
you? Yeah, I did.
You just got me to sign a white gumboot.
Yes.
What was all that about? What was I?
You know, the mental health sector's got a lot of issues, and one of the main issues in the sector that I work with young people is the waiting times to get counselling. And for the last couple of years, my charitable trust has been funding parents to get private care when their child is waiting too long and the need is now. So instead of doing what everyone else does and screams at the government and go, why don't you do more, we sat down and said, what can we do to help? So we've come up with this idea to try and raise $2 million per annum for free kids counselling for any parent out there that needs it. And the idea is called Gumboot Friday. So they say having depression is like walking through mud for 365 days a year. On April the 5th, the last Friday of daylight saving, we want everyone to go to work, go to school wearing their gumboots and walk through mud with people who are struggling. And along the way, donate money. You know, retailers put a gumboot on the counter. People put one coffee in the gumboot. Now, the big problem with fundraising is this. As a punter, I put my money in the gumboot and I walk away thinking how much goes to the kids and how much goes to administration. So we thought long and hard about that and we've come up with a solution. We don't touch the money. You deposit the money directly into the KiwiSaver Gumboot Friday account, and the only way that money comes out is with an invoice from a health professional. Mm. No accountancy invoices will be accepted.
All right. So you're talking about getting better access for younger people to look at their mental health issues. You were, 45 before you started to realise, hey, you've got some issues you need to look at?
Oh, it was probably about 47. I thought I was a drug addict and alcoholic. That's what I honestly, you know, I just thought I had a drinking and a drug problem. I didn't think I had any mental health issues. I didn't realise the two were related. So it took me till I was about 47 when, you know, I discovered my issues had their foundations in my self-esteem. So, as a kid growing up, I never felt like I had any value in the world at all. I had nothing to. I always thought other kids were better than me. My dad, who was my hero, I wanted to be my dad. You know, he's a great musician, great sportsman. He was great with his hands. He had lots of mates. He's a good-looking guy. I wanted to be like my dad. Sadly for me, I had feet for hands. I was useless at sport. I was tone deaf, and I was an ugly kid. So I always struggled. And then I discovered comedy. And a friend of mine told a joke one day. No one laughed. I told the joke. Everyone laughed. And it was the greatest day of my life.
Man, that's a tough gig for confidence, though, isn't it?
But as soon as they laughed, I felt like I had some value. For the first time in my life, I actually felt like I had something to offer the world, this gift of laughter. So from that day forward, all I wanted to do was make people laugh. So that was day one of my comedy career at 8 years old. As it turns out, that was day one of my downfall. Why? Because that was the first day that I started to get my self-esteem from the approval of other people. That was the first day I got my confidence from the approval of other people. That was the first day that other people took control of my life. Why? Because if you want approval, even on a subconscious level, you have to submit to others' wills. Otherwise, you fear isolation. You risk being burnt. Why I'm stressing this point is after traveling around schools around the country and speaking to over 200,000 kids over the last 6 years, what I've discovered is 90%, upwards of 90% of our kids out there today are currently getting their self-esteem from the approval of other people. 90% of our kids are getting their confidence from the approval.
How do you, for those who will be nodding their heads in their cars or lounges now listening to you, how do you get away from that?
So the reason they've got, you know, the reason they get in their self-esteem from the approval of others is because they don't feel like they're being approved of by the significant adults in their life. This is not my opinion. This is what kids have been telling me. So there are two things that kids want more than it. They'll take the PlayStations, they'll take the toys, they'll take the Lego, they'll take whatever you want to give them. But there's two things they genuinely want. Love. All kids want to be loved. But more importantly, kids want to know that their thoughts and opinions are valued by the significant adults in their life. Mm. Now, we think we value our kids' thoughts and opinions, but we really sit there with a fix-it hammer and go, what's the problem, what's the problem, what's the problem? Well, stay off the internet. What's the problem? Well, don't hang out with that guy.
So you know, your message this morning is more to the parents, say, than the
kids? Always, always. There's nothing wrong with the kids. Yeah. This is the problem. Our generation go, what's wrong with these? Nothing. They're perfect. We're breaking them.
Hey, just in the last few minutes that we've got, I want to talk about, because we talked briefly about your journey and then your comedy. Then you end up kind of, well, not quite in the bureaucracy, but trying to fix these problems and working with some of the professionals and the bureaucrats on this stuff, and that's pretty hard in itself. And then you were quite critical, weren't you, from memory, about the suicide target, and we had that issue. And now we've got this big mental health inquiry, and some working groups sort of set up around that too. Where do you think we're at with that process, Mike, and what do you think we're going to get from it in the end?
Well, first point, I applaud the government for doing their inquiry. Second point, my biggest fear about the inquiry is we're going to throw a whole lot of money at a whole lot of people trying to please everyone, and you're going to end up pleasing no one. In other words, in my opinion, we are throwing money at a sinking ship. We've got a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity here, like the Mason Report, once-in-a-lifetime opportunity where we can build a new ship. So currently, the ship that we're funding is centered around crisis. We fund crisis. Now, the problem with funding crisis is when you fund crisis, all you get is more crisis. And it's reactive. What I want us to be is proactive. So we need to be doing things at the top of the cliff rather than funding fire blankets at the bottom of the cliff. And that comes down to education in schools, educating parents about why we need to change our attitude. I want us to change our attitude, be more empathetic, make it more okay for our friends to come on and talk to us, not because it makes us kind human beings, not because it's about you, because we need to role model better behavior for our kids. If you're telling your kids, you can tell your kids that till they're blue in the face to do something. Kids don't learn by what we say, they learn by what they see. So if we want our kids to open up and talk about their issues, we want our kids to help other kids and be kinder, hey, we're the ones that have to lead the march. We're the ones that have to be kinder. We're the ones who have to be more empathetic.
All right. Hey, thanks very much for coming in with your gumboot. When was the gumboot day again?
April 5th, the last Friday before daylight saving. You know when it gets dark? Oh, it's the last one. So we want to turn it into a really happy event and do some good for our kids.
Well, those white gumboots are sharp, aren't
they? Yeah, shout out to Ocean Beach Freezing Works.
Thanks very much, Mike. Mike King. In the Auckland studio.